Hi, it's Stuart Sutton at 1 Acre Plus Homes with RE/MAX One. If you're thinking about buying a home on an acre or more, think about this. Find an agent with experience in the acreage area of real estate, because you're going to encounter some things you just will not experience when buying a home in a typical subdivision. Locations and niches. There are a lot of areas that you can buy homes on an acre or more. A lot of areas people aren't aware of. Valuation and negotiation. You do not want to pay too much for a house. In valuing a home on an acre more is not necessarily easy. It's not like valuing a home in a subdivision. In contract to close, there are considerably more costs in buying a home on an acre more. What do you need to spend and how important is that expenditure? Let's cover those real quick. This won't take but a few minutes. First of all, locations and niches. Where do you want to live? There are areas that have an abundance of homes on an acre or more, and other areas where they're harder to find. And if you absolutely want to live in a certain location, it may take you a little longer to find that house. Now, there are niches. There are a handful of homes in certain areas that people are not aware of that we have found for our clients. And those niches are not well known. As a matter of fact, I've had clients who bought a house from us in a little niche, and their friends have said, gosh, we didn't even know that existed. And we know where all these little areas exist because we've been doing this for so long. Restrictions are very important. Do you want an area that's highly restricted with an HOA, just like a subdivision in town? Or do you want someplace where you can park your boat in your RV? Maybe you want chickens, but you don't want the next door neighbor to be able to have a mobile home. Maybe you want a workshop. Maybe you don't care if the house across the street is worth a fraction of what yours is worth. There are lots of different areas and lots of different restriction levels. We'll talk about where you want to be and how you want to live. Performance. Different areas perform differently. Some areas with high restrictions perform very well. Some don't. Some with limited restrictions perform very well. Some don't. We know because we do statistics on virtually every area, every single year. We know what's going on. We know how these areas are performing. We know how they have performed and what their trends are. And the pricing is very important. You don't want to pay too much. Most agents just are not familiar with how to price a home on acreage. I've literally sold homes for about $800,000 that other agents insisted would be worth $1.1 million. That's an actual experience. Had another one where I really felt the home was worth around $625 to $640, and the agent thought it was worth $750. Well, my buyer bought it for $635,000 after all was said and done. You want to make sure that you don't pay too much for a house, because believe it or not, even appraisers aren't great with homes on acreage or more. And I'm not picking on appraisers, but it's a different methodology than typical subdivision housing. The price per square foot is not as big a factor as it is with subdivision housing. If you have an agent who's trying to compare houses on acreage by price per square foot, it's a hit and miss proposition. Anyway, you want to make sure you get a good value. You don't want to pay way too much for a house on acreage. I've seen it happen, and you don't want it to happen to you. The contract to closing process. There are costs involved with buying a home on an acre or more that are not included with a home in a subdivision. The inspections would include a home inspection and a termite inspection for a typical home. But when you buy a home on acreage, you have to add a septic inspection and a well inspection. And you might also have to inspect a workshop or outbuildings. And those add to the cost of the inspections. And with the septic inspection, for example, a lot of septic inspectors want the septic pumped. That's another cost. So you've got a cost for the inspection and you've got a cost for the pumping. You want to be familiar with and know what your expenses are when you're buying a home on an acre or more. There's a lot of things that are involved with a home on an acre or more that are not involved with a typical subdivision. Example, if you have to buy a survey, guess what? It's a lot more expensive with a home on acreage than a home in a subdivision. So you just want an agent who's familiar with what your costs are going to be so that you don't encounter surprises. That's kind of a brief overview. There are obviously a lot more factors, a lot more than I can cover in a few minutes. So thanks for listening. Feel free to contact me for a no hassle, no obligation consultation. See my information below if I can help in any way. Thanks so much. Make it a powerful day. Bye-bye.